OutRun hit US arcades in 1986. The game was developed and published by Sega. The game's graphics were 2D sprites, but they simulated 3D. The game was one long track, but featured branching paths, making the game non-linear. These paths differed in terms of difficulty, and you chose them by taking different routes that forked inside the level itself, making it ideal for multiple playthroughs. The game also had a unique amount of environments. From beach shores, fields, to European cityscapes, the amount of variety is very impressive for a racing game in 1986. What stood out the most, though, and led to the cabinet's overall success, were how well the graphics were in combination with the multiple paths one could take during a playthrough. The arcade had four cabinets, two stand-up cabinets, and two sit-down versions. However, the sit-down cabinet varied from standard to deluxe models, which featured different car parts. OutRun was the first arcade game that allowed the player to choose the music they wanted to hear for their playthrough. Granted, there were only three tracks, it was still something gamers and developers had not seen before. The team that developed the game was incredibly small, a total of 10 people, consisting of programmers, sound designers, and graphic designers. OutRun was heavily inspired by the feature film Cannonball Run, which released in 1981.
Because this is the Cannonball Run, America's illegal Grand Prix. And it doesn't matter how you get there, it's who gets there first. Burt Reynolds is the defending champion. On his team, Farrah Fawcett.
Are you one of those volleyballers?
Cannonballs.
The arcade game won multiple awards and sold over 30,000 units, which is incredibly good. The game was ported to nearly every home computer console, but for some reason, not the Nintendo Entertainment System. Probably because Sega was already planning on releasing their own console at that time. OutRun got four arcade sequels: OutRun 3D in 1988, Turbo OutRun in 1989, OutRunners in 1992, and finally, OutRun 2 in 2003. Eventually, the original arcade game was ported to the Game Gear, Sega Genesis, Sega Saturn, and finally, most recently, the Nintendo Switch. I always used to confuse this game with Rad Racer on the NES. Have a request for an arcade corner? Tweet me and include hashtag arcade corner. For more videos like this and everything else gaming related, you're already in my place. You're on ShaqNews.com. Next time on Shaq's Arcade Corner.